In this lecture, I will discuss on the economically important crops, that is, but in today's video, I'm going to discuss only on the important spices. Okay, so let us start here. The first spices that I want to discuss is on the red pepper, that is chilies. And the scientific name of red pepper is Capsicum annuum. Okay, the botanical name, as I had mentioned, is Capsicum annuum, and this red pepper, it belongs to the family Solanaceae, and in India, it is used to call by the names Lal Mirchi in Hindi, Marcha in Gujarati, Mirchi in Marathi, and etc. It has so many local names, okay, the vernacular names in India. And coming to the introduction of this plant, the Capsicum annuum, they are dried ripe fruits of this. The red pepper are the dried ripe fruits of Capsicum annuum, and they are native to tropical America and West Indies, and the plant is known since pre-Inca days. Okay, since that time, this particular crop is known. Pre-Inca days, that is during the largest empire in the pre-Columbian America. Okay, Inca are those dominant groups of South American people. So since that time, the red peppers are known. And this plant, fragments of red pepper, they have been recovered from the Mexican caves dating to about 7000 BC, and this crop is widely spread throughout the New World tropics in the pre-Columbian times. Okay, and it was introduced to India by the Portuguese in the 17th century, and therefore chilies are now cultivated mainly in the tropical and subtropical countries like Africa, India, Japan, Mexico, Turkey, and also in USA. And in India, they are grown practically all over India. Okay, in India. And but these red peppers, they are extensively cultivated in the Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Madhya Pradesh, Punjab, and Bihar. And about 1/4 of the total production of the country, it comes from Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka, and Tamil Nadu. So these four states. Okay, the total production of the country, it comes from these four states in India. Next, coming to the plant description, we have a red pepper plant is a small bushy annual. Okay, and you can see here with solitary and axillary flowers. Okay, you can see that the flowers, it occurs singly. These small white flowers, they occur singly and also axillary in between the leaf, okay, and the stem, so in the axil region. And also many seeded berries. You can see that when you cut open these berries of peppers, you will find that they have many seeds inside, right? And the fruits or the berries, they vary in shape and sizes. And the berries, they are usually green where unripe. Okay, they are green unripe, but then they turn red as they mature. As you can see here, some of the berries here are still green in color, but some they turn red as they mature. So that is the plant description. Now coming to the cultivation, chilies, they are essentially a tropical and subtropical crop, and also the rain fed crop It thrives best on deep, fertile, well-drained black cotton soils and also heavy clay loam. And it grows best in areas with an annual rainfall of 75 to 125 centimeter, but excessive rains during the growing period of the crop, the excessive rain as well as frost conditions, they are very harmful to the crop. And this particular crop, the red pepper, it is usually propagated by seeds. And the seedlings, they are raised in the nursery and planted in the field when they are about 4 to 5 weeks old. Okay, so the seedlings, they are raised in nursery and planted in the field when they are 4 to 5 weeks old. And the plant, it attains maturity in about 3 to 4 months only. And the fruits, as you can see, the fruits, they are picked with their stalk. Okay, you can see their stalk green in color here. They are usually picked with their stalk and they are stacked to ripen. And the ripe fruits, you can see the ripe fruits, they are dried in the sun or in a mechanical dryer, and they are sold whole or they are grounded to a desired mesh. And we have different varieties in India, different varieties of the different varieties of the red chilies or the red peppers, but here are some of the superior varieties of chilies which are cultivated in India are Pusa Jwala, then IC31339, PS313, LG1, PANT-C1 and CA33. These are some of the superior varieties which are cultivated in India. And different varieties of chilies, they vary in shape and sizes. Okay, they usually vary in their shape and color as well as size and the pungency of fruits, and also they vary in their chemical composition. So different varieties, these different varieties, they vary in their shape, their sizes, the pungency of the fruits as well as the color, and also their chemical composition, it varies from one species to the other. Now when we come to the composition, we have the, in general, the moisture is about 10%, proteins, we have different many nutrients, okay, are present in the in these red peppers. And some of the these are the composition, that is the moisture, proteins, fats, carbohydrates, fibers, then total ash, vitamins. And these are the vitamins which are present in red pepper chilies, that is riboflavin, niacin, vitamin, and also vitamin A. So the pungency of chilies is actually due to the presence of this compound known as the capsaicin, okay, known as the capsaicin, which is a crystalline phenolic substance. And the red color in the red peppers is usually due to the presence of these compounds: capsaicin, capsorubin, zeaxanthin, cryptoxanthin, lutein, and also the alpha and beta carotenes. These compounds, they impart the red color to the crop, to the plant. Now coming to the uses, the dried chilies, they are carminative, okay, they relieve the flatulence in the stomach. And they are extensively used as a spice. For also they are used, this we all know that the red peppers, they are mostly used for seasoning purposes, seasoning of food products, food preparations like egg, fish, meat, sauces, chutneys, pickles, all these, okay. And they are medicinally, okay, in, because we know that red peppers, they have medicinal properties, very important medicinal properties, and therefore medicinally they are used as counter irritants in lumbago neuralgia, alright, in lumbago neuralgia as well as rheumatism. Now lumbago neuralgia is a Lower back pain and rheumatism is the pain and inflammation in the muscles and joints. And it's also used, they are especially useful in atonic dyspepsia. This atonic dyspepsia is loss of tone in the digestive organ, okay? And the people having this, they have a little or no appetite. Thus, these red peppers are very useful in treating atonic dyspepsia. And in India, these red peppers, they are also used in ornamental strings and wreaths. Okay, that is the assortment of flowers or along with these peppers to form a ring. Okay, so these are the different uses of this important crop.